Coming up, we take a look at updates to how you can manage and secure distributed multi-cloud compute resources in Azure using Azure Arc. Now we're going to look at how this extends a unified management play into your virtual machines and physical servers on premises, including now your SQL servers wherever they are. To help me explain all the different updates that we have, I'm joined today by Travis Wright from the Azure Data Engineering Team. Welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics.
Yeah, thanks for having me back. It's great to be here.
So before we get started talking about all the different updates, just to recap if you're new to Azure Arc, really the easiest way to think about it is as a bridge that simplifies complex and distributed environments across on-premises, edge, and also multi-cloud into a unified central management plane in Azure. Now, you don't have to migrate these resources or move them to a common directory service. They simply stay where they are.
That's right. A lot of organizations have resources spread across data centers, other public clouds, and a lot of these just have different management tool sets. With Azure Arc, we're giving you a frictionless way of bringing together all the infrastructure and services that you have across the clouds, across all your data centers and edge site locations into a single consistent view and toolset. This includes providing some Azure services, such as data services, as we announced at Ignite. You can manage Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters and servers wherever they are from Azure. And you can manage your servers, whether that's Windows or Linux, at a platform level. And today at the hybrid virtual event, we're announcing that you can even manage Azure Arc-enabled SQL servers, allowing you to manage your SQL server workloads anywhere from Azure. Once it's under Azure Arc management, you'll be able to apply policy and govern those resources centrally and securely at scale.
That's right. And if you missed this at Ignite, that was a show that we had with Travis, you can also check that out at aka.ms/arcdatabase. Now, I know a lot of the updates really revolve here around Azure Arc-enabled SQL server. So can you tell us about the updates there?
Yeah, we think this is going to appeal to a lot of people because almost every organization we come across, they have lots and lots of SQL servers. Depending on where those SQL servers are, if it's on-premises or in AWS or in Azure, how you manage them really is kind of different. There's different tool set to them. And so Azure Arc greatly reduces this complexity by giving you a way to manage your entire SQL server estate from a single point of view and a single tool set from Azure.
And it sounds great, but can you tell us then kind of the machinery and how it all works?
Yeah, to bring your SQL servers under Azure Arc management, each SQL server has to have an agent installed on it. And then that agent needs to be able to securely establish that secure communication channel up to Azure. This enables secure bidirectional communication. So I'll show you how to get this up and running. Here's where you would see a list of Arc-enabled servers. Right now I have none, so let's get one going. First, we'll need to get Windows Server under management and then the SQL instance. I'll click Create. You can choose to do this at scale by creating a script, which will use a service principal to onboard. You could then deploy that script with something like System Center or your favorite software distribution tool. For this demo, we'll use the interactive script, which will prompt me to log into Azure. I'll choose the subscription, resource group, and region as usual. Then I'll choose Windows or Linux and then click Review and Generate to generate the script. The script contains all the information that it needs, including your tenant ID, subscription ID, and resource group, so that it can securely broker a trust relationship to Azure. Now I'll download the script, and from here, execute the script. That's now going to log me into Azure. I just need to paste in my authentication key. So once I'm logged in, the script will complete, and we can switch over to Add Remove Programs, Refresh, and see that the Azure Connected Machine Agent is installed. And if we go back to the portal, to the machine's Azure Arc view, we'll see it show up there. We can drill into it and see some of the details about it, such as the computer name and operating system information. So now this server is Arc-enabled and can be managed from Azure.
Right, and so to be clear here, we've brought in the Windows component into management, but we still need to tackle the SQL instance aspects of management as well.
Yeah, exactly. That's the next step. So now we're going to manage the SQL server running on that Arc-enabled server. So starting where we left off, looking at the Arc-enabled server named SQL Server 01, I'll follow the same general process of generating and downloading a script. I'll go to the SQL Server's Azure Arc view, then click Add, and you'll be prompted to select your subscription and resource group, instance name, location, username, password, and then click Review and Create. I've already done that to save time. I have the script here and I'm going to run it. So now this is installing the SQL Server extension to the Azure Arc agent and configuring it to discover the SQL Server instance. Just to confirm that it worked, I'll hit refresh in the Azure portal, and now we can see that there is an Arc-enabled SQL Server, and we can start to manage the SQL Server from Azure.
Got it. So once everything is under management with Azure Arc, what are some of the examples then where this gets even more powerful?
Yeah, so one of the best examples is with security operations. Not many people know this, and it's actually kind of hard to fathom it, but Microsoft spends about $1 billion a year and has 3,500 dedicated engineers constantly doing security research. And we enable you to benefit from that investment that Microsoft makes by providing you these services like advanced threat protection, vulnerability assessment, and Azure Sentinel. So let me show you. Here I have an Arc-enabled SQL Server. Azure Arc extends Azure Security Center's vulnerability assessment and advanced threat protection services out to these SQL servers in my own data center. So let's take a look at the security tab to see what might currently be recommended for me. Vulnerability assessment has a high severity recommendation for me to take a look at. Let's drill in. Here's a classic example of a security best practice that hasn't been followed in this case. The SA login is enabled, and the vulnerability assessment is recommending that it should be disabled. Vulnerability assessment will tell me the reasons why this change should be made and even provide me with the exact T-SQL script to run to disable it. By going back now, we can see that advanced threat protection has detected a brute force attempt. My guess is that this is related to the fact that the well-known SA login was enabled. Here we can see that there were 30 failed login attempts with the SA login. Let's see what the action is that is recommended by advanced threat protection. So it looks like the recommendations are to block the IP address of the client that was doing the attack. Also, it looks like we can protect ourselves better by disabling the SA login, which we've already done. Lastly, we can see that this is all integrated with Azure Sentinel so that our SecOps team can see these incidents there in a central location. They can further investigate the issue by using Sentinel's advanced logging analysis and visualization tools.
That's an awesome example in terms of security, but what about day-to-day operations and config management? How does that help us here?
Yeah, configuration management is a big advantage of Azure Arc. One of the best ways to show this is through the Azure policy, which we can see here. Azure policy helps bring existing infrastructure into a compliant state or ensures that services are compliant as they are provisioned, and we can track our compliance here in the Azure policy compliance dashboard. Policies define desired configuration, and we can provide hundreds of policy templates, or you can create your own. So let's take a look at some of the policy templates that we provide. We'll search for the SQL-related ones using the search box. Here's a policy template to enable transparent data encryption on all our SQL databases. This will automatically encrypt all data at rest without requiring any app changes. We can look at the details of this, and then we can assign it to a scope. A scope is a subscription and resource group. So here we would target the same subscription and resource group that we just created the Arc-enabled SQL Server in, and this policy would be applied to it. Since this takes a few minutes to apply, I won't actually create it right now. But by creating a policy like this, it would send down the policy to the Arc-enabled SQL Server in my data center, and all of the databases on that SQL Server would then be encrypted with transparent data encryption. And then any future Arc-enabled SQL servers that are added to that resource group will also have that policy applied to them, and all of their databases would automatically be encrypted as well.
And this is really going to help in terms of consistency, but most of what you're showing here is related to servers. Now, last time you were on, you talked about Arc-enabled Kubernetes and really some of the things that you can do with data services as well. So what are some of the updates there?
Right. So at Build, we announced the public preview of Arc-enabled Kubernetes, which enables you to take any Kubernetes cluster you have anywhere, register that with Azure, and then it becomes manageable by Azure, including the ability to integrate it with Azure Monitor. So we can collect monitoring and performance statistics about that Kubernetes cluster and send that up to Azure Monitor so you can see that information across all your Kubernetes clusters in a single view in the Azure portal. So if I flip over to Azure Monitor, I can see near real-time state of my nodes and pods across all of my Kubernetes clusters. This blue oval under the icon indicates these Kubernetes clusters are outside of Azure. I'll drill into one, and you'll see the overall performance of the cluster here in this dashboard. You can see node CPU utilization, memory utilization, and node and pod counts over time. And also, we can see the overall state of the infrastructure, and I can see details about the nodes and controllers. Lastly, I can see both my apps and Arc-enabled data services running in these containers. These particular containers that you see here are running Azure Arc-enabled data services.
Okay, so now you can actually monitor your Kubernetes clusters everywhere centrally from one place using Azure Monitor. Now, it's awesome to see all the different progress that you and your team have made in the couple of months, but what's happening next?
Yeah, so we're going to continue bringing Azure services to be enabled for customers to run wherever they want through Azure Arc. Concretely, there's a couple of things we're working on in data services right now. The first is that we're going to enable you to take backups locally and then send those backups up to Azure for long-term offsite retention in Azure. And then secondly, you know, really what management system would be complete without the ability to do automated patch and update management? So that's a really key feature that we're building, and we're really excited to deliver that to customers so they can patch their Arc-enabled data services anywhere, whether that's in their own data center, in edge site locations, or other public clouds from the context of Azure.
Thanks, Travis. And really, as someone who grew up also with systems management, I'm going to be watching this space super closely as it develops. And if you want to get started with Azure Arc, be sure to check out aka.ms/AzureArcData and sign up for the preview. Of course, also keep following all the updates across Microsoft on Microsoft Mechanics. That's all the time we have for this show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.